Welcome back to Clyde's Farm, everybody, and welcome to episode 8 of Western Wilds. As feared, in November, about 3:30, we started to lose the light. So all we managed to do was get the ploughing finished, and then it was too dark to do anything. It's actually a lot darker than what it is at the moment. So you join us in December. We are currently heading to the shop to hire a stone picker, and today we will mostly be concentrating on getting our grass stroke cow field up and running. So as usual, we have stone picking, liming, fertilising, seeding and fertilising to do on that field. We have topped up the sawmill with wood this morning. As you can see, our money has gone up, not to the £195,000 that we're trying to save up for the wood pellet production. But next month we do get to sell our silage bales. We will actually see where we are once we've got this field finished, because on some maps, January and December give you the same price on silage. On some months it's January and February that give you the same price. So into the shop, into stone pickers, and you'll see there's three options, and the only real difference is the speed. So 8 mile an hour, 15 mile an hour, or 31 miles an hour. I'm going to go for the middle one. It's just a little bit more controllable. So we'll lease that for nearly 3,000. The shop have said that once we're finished with it, just park it up on the yard. They will come and collect it at their convenience, which is good of them. Sun's starting to break through. Looked at the weather forecast today, but nothing in the near future. Well, the only thing that would really stop us doing what we're doing at the moment is if we got snow and it's settled. Just snowing, we can carry on. Raining, we can carry on. So if you haven't seen this stone picker mod before, there's two arms folded up at the front of the trailer. You'll see when we unfold it, they will come out, we'll lower them. They drag the stones along those spikes that you can see, and the pickup puts them in the trailer. Whatever we get, obviously we will go and put into the farm factory to make some more lime. We are going to empty the line out of there on the next stage of this field. Obviously this put our plans back a month, so the grass that's going to go into the farm factory to make TMR is now not going to be ready until April, which, to be honest, isn't much of a concern, because the cows are a way off at the moment. It just means that the grass and, do you know what, we could have carried on down that road, I think. The grass and the barley are going to be ready in the same month. Which again isn't an issue, we'll cope. Trees, you can see a ploughed field, so let's get this, let's get the folding, unfolding started. Load, turn it on. Cruise control on. So you get about between 11,000 and 12,000 litres of those 2 kilos there. So you're happy with 5,000 litres of stone of this one. Anything else is going to be a bit of a bonus. We will run a bit of a headwind first. Stone you've got, the more line you can make, then you need to be less likely to have to go and buy it. Which means we reach our financial goals that we closer along the way, the quicker. No other jobs to do today apart from sort this deal out, so we can do it 100% concentration. Field throws a tractor all over the place and you're constantly steering. You see how difficult it is to sit stone at the moment, and then you turn around at the bottom, they're all here. Thousands of dollars being kicked, so we're hoping that by the time we plow again, we'll have the money to buy it. Buy another business reason. And then there's a similar bit of kit, grass collecting and paper and straw. 4,000 litres. Whereas to start with, especially the grass up this field, we're going to bale and then throw it straight into the TMR factory. Once we've got the money, we'll buy the grass collecting version of this and we'll be able to just collect it as grass. Out the baling and the collection of the bales and just literally go dump it straight in the TMR factory. This job compared with the in-game they might be people had to get on this extremely possible number 6. And quite a lot of people don't play with stone one with it, so it just takes us so long to collect them. This stones, together. Fill it up as much as you can from the farm factory. And work away on this field. Doing the lawn spreading. Just as good enough. Great animation on this. When we fold up. And we'll see when we empty it, they fold out like stabilizers. Let the shop know that it's ready to collect. Okay, one. Myself, but when things are tight, I sometimes think the worker does a better job than me. Do that sometimes. you'll find with this is if you get a bump that's a bit big, because that rear bar of the spreader is bridging it, so sometimes it bangs up and you miss a stretch. Grand scheme of things, with the yield that's going to not make that much of a difference. 8 degrees, sun shining. Seven assignment fails. I'm putting in all the television action. Unless we get to do this wrap this month, and that will depend on A, do we have any daylight left when we finish the game? Probably. And B, what sort of price we get for the silent fails in December rather than selling in January. Thought it was going to be, and we're not going to have a great deal left. But then, in theory, we haven't got any lining to do for a while. Because we're going to put the chocolate factory in, once we've got cows going, we're going to need sugar. We're going to be growing sugar beet, which in itself is another big expense. We need a separate harvester for that, but it also means that you have to plow half of every harvest of sugar beet. So we should have a constant supply of stones to turn into lime. Thank you. happened before. But it's not a disaster. We're not going to do smooth, we're going to do sharp. Into those corners. Okay. Set it away. Let's go and have a look at these prices. So, silage. Yes, we know. Train yard. And yes, actually, December is the best time to sell it. And not in January as suspected. However, we haven't done a full year yet, so we'll hold judgment on that. So what we will do is we will jump in. Pick up and get a flatbed and sell the silage off, and then you might have to move a few things. Because ideally just where those cedar and that is parked would be where I would like to put in the wood pellets. Unless we did it up, we could do it with this end, I suppose, where the silage bales are. Or silage bales somewhere else, not a bad idea. Right, so we've got one left over. We'll snip up something like we did last time. Give us the means. That's a vehicle, right? Yeah, this is where I should be. Gold nuggets, last reported sightings, 20 to find.
Red pins not found, green pins collected. And that's that one that we collected right in the corner. And we are over here, somewhere, there. Ah, okay, that's handy to know. So, I saw something shining. There, look. Can we swim over and get it? That's going to be too easy, isn't it? Okay. I'm not going to be able to jump over, so there's got to be something tenty. What else have we got around here? Barbecue tables. Oh, what's that? Enable. Where did I just find? Enable cheat platform. What's that? Right, now all we've got to do is get across here without falling off, which he did straight away. Glad he needs this, isn't it? Okay, let's try that again. So I just saw something out of the corner of my eye. We were so close. I think I desperately need the money after we sell these silage bales, but it's money towards our next purchase, which we know will be a harvester. Collect. 50,000, that one. Oh, what's that up there? That's a library. Okay. I'm happy. Right, let's go and sell these bales. So our fertiliser spreader has finished, so we'll leave the fertiliser spreader by the field because we know we need a second stage, and start the seeder off. got more than enough now to do our wood pellet factory. So that's good. Wood pellet production in. Set sawmill to distribute the wood chip. Hopefully that works. As I may end up putting in some sort of conveyor system to get it off the floor and into the trailer. So once we've done that, we'll scootle off to the shop, get that film. Get all the wheels as we can in back on the pickup for now. Do we just treat ourselves because we got that 50k that we weren't expecting? spin round so we can see what's going on. Production. Guarantee it'll be right at the end. One of the last things I installed. That swamp's there, look. And that's the open side, so yeah, we need all four of them moving. Okay, so we're going to need the tractor to do that moving. So we will come off to the shop. Trailer with sides on it. I don't really want to be back to the horse in the shop every other month for my film. As if I can throw a load in the back of the trailer and fill the back of the pickup up. So we are at the end of this episode. So I am literally going to get to the shop and then I'm going to start. Whilst things are going on in the background, I'm going to end the episode and I will bring you back in exactly the same place so you can see what's going on. So thanks for watching, everybody, and we'll see you very soon. Goodbye. The sun's sinking low.